Welcome to Control Lens Reporting Facility Migration Video. In this video, you will see how to migrate existing Control Lens Reporting Facility report definitions into the new Control Lens reports and how to replace and update jobs that run these reports in Control Lens Client. In Control Lens in version 9.18, you can no longer run Control Lens Reporting Facility reports and jobs, so instead you need to migrate to Control Lens reports. You don't need to migrate the BMC supplied reporting facility templates. Only your own templates need to be migrated. New BMC templates are included in Control Lens reports, such as alerts, active jobs, job definitions, and so on. Control Lens reporting facility migration is a three-part process which consists of the following. Part 1, pre-installation planning and installation of Control ME in version 9.18, including Control Lens Automation API. Part 2, migration of your old data and reports into Control Lens reports. And part 3, job definition. You need to define a job using Automation API and then update the jobs of Control Lens client using the command defined in Automation API. Before installing version 9.18, we need to plan the migration by using the RF Jobs Analyzer utility, which comes with the installation CD. The utility generates a report which contains the following information. Identification of hosts that run reporting facility. Detailed information about each job that runs these reports, which will need to be updated. And view general warnings about the migration process. To start the process, from the installation DVD, go to Setup, underscore Files, Tools, Reporting. Move the reports underscore jobs underscore analyzer folder to a specific Control MEM server where we want to run the utility. In this case, you will see we have moved it to the desktop reporting directory, but it can be anywhere on your EM server. Let's open a command prompt. Go to the reports underscore jobs underscore analyzer folder and type the following command. Run underscore RF underscore jobs underscore analyzer and press enter. A summary appears on screen. To see the details of the report, open the text file, the location of which is mentioned here. Let's open the text file. In this example, you will see at the top of the report there is a general summary which shows we have two jobs running on the host. If we scroll down, you can see a breakdown of both jobs. The first job is a Control-M OS job. You can see the job name, folder name and other details, including the command, which will need to be updated later. The second job is a Control-M Reports job. Again, you can see the job details. Finally, note the general warnings. We need to check if there are OS jobs containing scripts which run EM Reports CLI. And there's a reminder for us that EM Reports CLI EXE is no longer supported. These two jobs need to be updated, which we will deal with later. Now we can proceed with installation. The next step is to install Control MEM version 9.18. Ensure that we do not upgrade the Control M client running the EM Reports CLI EXE until the migration process has ended. Now we can proceed with the migration. The next step is to migrate reporting facility report definitions to the new Control M report. You need to run the EM Report CONV CLI EXE utility. This utility converts existing reporting facility RPT files to Control Lens Reports JSON files. On the CD, go back to the same directory as before, and this time move the report conversion CLI folder to the reporting facility client machine, which we identified in the RF Jobs Analyzer utility report. You will see we have placed it in the reporting folder, but it doesn't have to be in any particular location. Before we start, we need to find out where the RPT files are located. By default, the files are in EM Installation, Default, Data, Reporting and Templates. We've also created a new file for the new reports, Reporting Conversion CLI, Converted Reports. Now let's convert the folders by running the utility. Go to the Report Conversion CLI folder and type the following. EM Report CONV CLI .exe-s, source folder where the RPT files are located, -d, destination folder where the new files will be located. Press enter. You can see both the alert sample report and job definition sample report have been converted. There is also confirmation of the source and destination folders. To check, let's open the destination folder and you'll see both reports are now in the folder, plus a report conversion summary. Let's open this file and you'll see details of the conversion. Now we can import those reports into Control-M Reports. From the V918 client, open Control-M Reports. Click Report and then select Load from File. Navigate to the converted reports folder. Firstly, select Alert Sample Report, and click Open and then click Save. Review the contents and verify the output. Let's do the same for the Job Definition Sample Report. Select Load from File, click Open and then click Save. Again, review the contents and verify the output. The reports have now been migrated into Control-M Reports. As like any other report, you can edit, generate or delete the report as you wish. For more information, see Control-M Reports online help. Part 3, Job Definitions. In Control-M Client, the following job types no longer run. Control-M Report and OS jobs running the EM Report CLI command. These jobs need to be updated by doing the following. Define a new command in Automation API. Ensure that you have already installed a configured Automation API before you start. For more information, see Automation API online help. Then you need to manually update the jobs in Control-M Client with the new command defined in Automation API. Let's define a job in Automation API. In this example, we have two reports that we have defined and want to run in Automation API. Alerts_sample_report and job_definition_sample_report. Let's start with the alerts sample report. Open a command line and type the following. CTM reporting report get, then the name of the report we want to order, which is alerts_sample_report, then the report output format with PDF-O, and the full name of the output file, which is ctemp_alerts_pdf. Press Enter, and you'll see the output has now been generated. Let's do the same for the job definition sample report. Again, let's type CTM reporting report, get job_definition_sample_pdf-O, ctemp job definition pdf, press Enter, and you will see the job definition output file has been generated. Now go to the temp file and we can see both files. Click Alerts file and then do the same for job definition. The final step is to update report jobs in Control-M Client. Open the client and you will see we have two jobs that run reports that need to be updated. OS jobs running EM report CLI, in this example, runs the job definition sample report, and Control-M report job type. And this example runs the sample alerts report. For the OS job running the EM report CLI.exe, we need to update the command. So in the command field, delete the current command and replace it with the one defined in Automation API, which is CTM reporting report get job_definition_sample_pdf-O_ctemp_definition_pdf, and then click OK. As the Control-M report job type doesn't run, we've created a new OS job type. Open the OS job type and you will see we have copied the details. In the command line, add the command that we defined in Automation API. CTM reporting report get alert sample report pdf-O_ctemp_alerts_pdf, then click OK. You can then delete the Control-M report job type. You can edit or change any of the other definitions as usual. Ensure that the environment where you run the new report jobs is set up correctly and has access to all the environmental variables required to run Automation API. Check in the jobs and then click Order. Let's go to the monitoring domain and we can see that the jobs ended OK. This now concludes the migration process. For more information about reporting facility migration, see the Reporting Facility Migration online help.